Hi, this is Patrick with a quick tip on preparing to list e-commerce products to the web store. E-commerce product groups do not show in your web store until you map them to a category. The client import product mapping import is a great option for bulk listing, aftermarket, and custom private catalog product groups. First off, before listing products to the web store, you should confirm any new products are complete and ready for public viewing. Please find the link below to the Adding Custom E-commerce Products checklist and confirm the items you intend to list have all required information added. Customers should only encounter complete products on your e-commerce web store, allowing them to shop with confidence. If all products are prepared for listing, we're ready to go. Now, let's prepare the import. One last note, if you have less than 20 items that need an edit, you may prefer to list your products in the interface. If so, see the link below the video for information. First, we'll export current product mapping. This export can be used as an import file once we remove just two columns, which means we won't have to build the entire import file by hand. First, open e-commerce. Go to File Center. On the left-hand menu, under Web Store Categories and Products, click Client, Export Product Mapping. Enter your email, or you won't be notified when the job is done. Click Submit. This is a large export that includes both private catalog and aftermarket product group mappings. Plan on up to 30 minutes for it to complete. Once you receive the job complete notification email, open File Center. Click on the export. Click Client Export Product Mapping Report.csv to download the export file. Let's open the file and go over the fields you'll see. Catalog.name and product group.id. These are required fields. E-commerce uses these values to look up the product group you wish to edit. Please do not edit values in these fields. Product group.name and manufacturer group.name. These fields will need to be removed for our import. They are used to help you find the products you wish to edit. Webstore category.path is the field you will be editing. This field allows you to list a product group to a category in your web store. Be warned, leaving webstore category.path blank will delist a product, removing it from your store non-destructively. Products can be relisted with a second import, so sometimes this is desirable. The webstore category.path value must contain the exact category name and have one space between each category and separating angle bracket for a successful import. If a category you wish to use is not present in your export, confirm the exact category names in the interface. In e-commerce, click Categories and browse to the correct category. Once you have entered your category, you will want to confirm the formatting. You should see plenty of examples in your export, so compare existing category paths against any you have edited, and consider just copying over any categories that you wish to use. Please be aware you should not make use of any aftermarket categories for private catalog products. We do not recommend updating aftermarket product in general other than delisting them to remove them from the web store, as they will occasionally be updated automatically by the system. You may ignore all other fields when listing or remapping product categories. If you are interested in these fields, please see the link below for a complete list of product mapping import functions. Now, let's check a few things. Imports can often take hours, so do it right the first time, especially since this import sets your data live in front of customers. First, are you listing new product groups? If so, please make sure your products are ready for sale. Have you also finished the basic e-commerce checklist? Products can be listed to your web store at any time, but if you have not finished the basic e-commerce setup checklist, your e-commerce platform may not be configured to generate leads, allow purchases, or deliver on goods. Please see the link below the video if you need to reference the basic e-commerce setup checklist. The import accepts files of up to about 10 megabytes, or roughly 150,000 rows, but an import that large may take a full day to process. We recommend removing most rows you do not intend to update for a faster import. Make sure your entries do not have any trailing spaces in edited rows. Check spelling for items that you enter. Typos can prevent rows from importing if they do not match the actual category name. Once you are happy with your sheet, delete the product group.name and manufacturer group.name columns. Then save the CSV as a copy with a new name. This should now be a valid import sheet. This has been a quick tip. Thank you for your time.